that is subtraction of time, subtraction of time, that is here also hour and minutes. Okay, that is 5 hour 10 minutes, 2 hour. Okay, here no minutes. Okay, that is subtraction means remain this same, that is 0 and 1, and 5 minus 2, that is 3. That is 3 hours 10 minutes is the answer. Okay, that is 5 hours 10 minutes minus 2 hours. Okay, that means 5 minus 2 3, here 10 minutes. Okay, and one more example for that is hour and minute. Okay, that is for here, that is 9 and 2, here 15 and 60. Okay, ten, 60. So minus, that is 9 hour 10 minutes. You have to subtract 2 hour 60 minutes from 9 hour 10 minutes. Okay, here you can't subtract the, that is 10. Okay, so you can't subtract 60 from 10. Okay, this is a bigger number and this is a smaller number. So you have to carry over that is give 1 hour, that is 60 minutes to this. Okay, 60 minutes to this, that means okay 1 hour. 60 minutes means here 60 plus 10 70. Okay, here you carry over, borrow 60, that is 1 hour from this. That is 1 hour is equal to again 60 minutes, you know. That is 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes, and 60 plus 10, that is 70. Okay, and that is here 70 minutes, 70 plus 60, that is 10 minutes, and this is a 8 hour, and 8 minus 2, that is 6. Okay, so that's the hour you have to subtract 2 hours 60 minutes from 9 hour 10 minutes. That is the answer is 6 hours, okay, 10 minutes. Okay, do you understand this? Because you can't subtract 60 from 10. So, borrow 1 hour from this, and 1 hour is 60 minutes. That is 60 plus 10, 70. 70 minus 60, that is 10 minutes. Here, that is borrow one number to this because it less to one number and it is as 8. So 8 minus 2, 6 hours. So this is a concept, that is a without borrowing minutes, and here borrowing minutes from nearby hours unit. Okay, and next we move on to the time duration between days. Okay, let me learn. Our topic is time duration days. Okay, how to calculate the time duration of days in between important two events. Okay, let me calculate how to calculate. Okay, this is a real life mathematical application. Okay, I'm going to write one word problem, it's an event, and we are going to calculate the days between these two events. How to do this? Okay, let me see. That is, I am going to write the question. That is, Sam is a person. Okay, Sam's birthday, okay, falls on April 12. Okay, Sam is a person. Sam's birthday falls on March 12. Okay, his friend John's birthday, okay, falls on 4th May. Okay, how many time days between these two birthday? Okay, both of birthday. Okay, calculate. Okay, the number of days between these two events. Okay, first read the question. Sam's birthday falls on March 12. His friend John's birthday falls on 4th May. Okay, calculate the number of days between these two events. First you have to calculate, that is you will not be add that 12 date. Okay, and you have to add the date of 4. Okay, remind this, leave with that March 12th day. Okay, first you have to, that is 31 minus 12, because March has 31 days. By calculating your first calculation, that's a knuckle portion, that is January, February, March. Okay, that March has 31 days. So 31 minus 12. Okay, for March, that is 31 minus 12. Okay, so 31 minus 12, to subtract the number, that is, okay, carry over, that is 11. 11 minus 2, that is 9. Here 2 minus 1, that is 19. So total days 19 March. Okay, and April, the number of days for April, that is 30. Okay, and May, it has 4 days, because 4th May is a John's birthday. Okay, so that is May, it has, that is 4. So add these two numbers, that is 19 plus 30 plus 4. Okay, that is 19, 30 plus 4. Add all these three numbers, that is 13 plus 1. Okay, that is 53. That is 53 days. Okay, this is the answer. So how we calculate the number of days between these two events means total number of days, that is 53 days. Okay, so this is the time duration days calculation, how to calculate. Okay, that's for so many examples, taken out your NCERT book or any workbook. Remind one thing, that sir, you should not add the date, this date will not be added this. Okay, so count the number of days of those, that specific month, whether it is a November, December, you have to calculate 31 or 30 days from your first calculation. Okay, and between the month also you have to put the number, that is April has 30 and May, that means you will be add that day also. 4th May means you have to 4 days, because here 11th May means you have to put 11. You have to add those on specific date also. Okay, and put all these number and add to calculate the days, that is 53 days. So we have discussed so many subtopics in our time chapter. Okay, I hope you can receive so many, that is calculation method and simple techniques, how to calculate the time concept. Okay, please share it with your friends and relatives and support our Pebbles channel. Thank you.